Hi, this is Irina for Savarez TV, and I'm very happy to introduce my new album, It's About the Touch.
This is Matt for Savarez TV. I'm right now online with Irina Kulikova, who's in The Hague in the Netherlands. How's it going, Irina?
Great, very good. We have a lot of sunny weather now, and it's spring finally is coming into our home.
So I gathered that you're here with us to talk about your latest record. Could you tell me a little bit about it?
Yeah, so welcome to my home, and it's my personal CD. It's About the Touch, that actually I dedicated to my monkey, to my little daughter. She will be 9 this year, and my dream was to, when she was born, I wanted to give her a musical present. So it's like this, it's really with all the personal touch to her favorite pieces, and well, with a picture with her, and also with a song that dedicated to her. So it's really, when she was born, I had a dream to do this CD with a special music from the heart when she's around 8 years old. So, and it happened. So the CD is out. It's a present for her, but it's also for us to share our love, our favorite music with the whole world. So it's it's like this. It's from home to your home.
Well, that's really, really nice, and it's a present for her. But I'm sure that you'll agree with me if you think that your daughter is a present for you, because today is a very special day for you, and the whole team in Savarez wish you a very happy birthday, Irina. It's right now today.
Thank you so much. My daughter was my present for my 30th birthday. So today I turned 39. And I've been traveling a lot for concerts, and then I wanted to make a break, and I thought like, wow, that would be so great to have a child as your, you know, jubilee present. And I wanted to have a summer girl, so all my dreams came true. And so she is my birthday present for life, for my 30th birthday. And yes, thank you so much also for all your wishes, and happy to celebrate this birthday together with you.
It's a lovely way to celebrate. We're honored to have you online on this very special day anyway, and it's a really good, it's a nice adventure, first of all, for all of you who have kids out there, and it's a lovely adventure playing music, and Irina is obviously mixing all that and enjoying her life to the full potential, so congratulations on everything. Shall we talk about, by the way, I love the way in the record, the actual CD, it looks like a kind of vinyl. If I saw it correctly, that's nice.
So, also the touch to the cover, it's not just like paper. It's very nice to hold it in hand. And of course, like we also have the digital stream, but this is more like really the thing to have, you know, to touch. And this, yes, it has a little extra, design. That nice. Was possible to do, so a little bit like the gramophone plate, or yeah. And this is just like when you open, it's like you go in the guitar, because this guitar Simon Marty made for me, and with this.
It's the same guitar.
Yes. So it has a lot of really personal things in the CD. So it's a little bit like having a diary, Irina's diary, but you know, expressing my life. Thinks what I do, thinks what I believe in, with the music. So, and it has also a song that her daddy wrote for her, and it's been originally written for piano and voice, but when I heard how they've been playing it together and had fun with the song, I thought, wait a minute, it could be amazing on the guitar. So I recorded this song as well on the CD, because Marielle, Be As Beautiful As You, with a nice lyrics to the song that I did an instrumental version of it. And there is also a piece written for the Three Night Ballads for cello and guitar. It also has a personal touch in my, well, in my life, in my story, and also a photo in New York with Felix Valajanin, the cellist. We record a CD. So all this CD actually has every piece, every little detail has a personal touch to my life.
Yeah, so it's not just the touch when you actually touch the strings and play the guitar, but it's the touch in the music, the sensitivity, and I can see that because the one thing that strikes me when I listen to your music is the emotion side. You're very emotional when you play, and it really translates through your playing, from my humble perspective anyway. And I can see you've done the same thing with the actual object, the CD. You're talking about how it feels, how
it's
you can
like
touch
I'm
it.
It's like an actress on the guitar, you know, or a film director on the guitar, and with everything is around it, because, well, that matters for me. It is my personal touch.
Yeah, because I suppose music is always a reflect of our own personality, so
world, how we feel the world, and that's why I was not afraid to pick up some pieces like already recorded million times, also the Albanese Asturias and the Schubert, the Serenade, and well, the Tariga Capriccio Arabe, and Maria Gavot, and all many like famous pieces. Everyone has their own identity when they play. And I try, of course, always to understand the composer idea, but then plus my own feeling of here and now, because some composers, they're not alive anymore, right? And just bringing it into the future with my perspective, with my feelings, right? And with my knowledge, experience. And that's what I find always so special. Like, we have so many recordings and they're all so different.
Do you feel any difference when you're playing a piece that was made by a modern composer that's like still alive today? And how does it, do you feel different? Do you interpret differently a piece that was made, you know, centuries ago by a composer that's not around these days? I mean, it's obviously a totally different approach.
For me, it's really a magic, and I think this is one of the reasons why I really love to be in music, and especially in classical guitar, because I feel like I have the magic, you know, traveling. Well, it's
traveling back in time.
Because it's a magic guitar, yeah, traveling in time, traveling in epochs, because with the music, when you touch, like with the Bach, right, and it's like been composed, it came first into the mind of a great guy who just, well, had an idea to have this beautiful, very simple notes, and then like how they flow into, you know, like his writing, you know, on the paper and fixing it on the paper, and then after so many years, you know, like and a girl in the 21st century picks up that music and plays from, you know, like so many centuries between us, and it's still from this planet. It is, you know, it always gives me goosebumps. It's so always exciting. And then reading also the books about you know, that architecture, the paintings of the time, how they lived before, there were no mobile phones, you know, no Skype, no Google, it was a different life, and how to kind of, you know, find the right interpretation from nowadays to, you know, express what they've been thinking and feeling. Definitely they've been feeling something with the music as well. It's always about the feelings, right? The music.
Okay, so to talk maybe more specifically about the guitar, did you use exclusively only that guitar on the CD? And maybe you could tell us a little bit about your guitar, the luthier, etc.
Actually, I have two babies, and they're both from Australia by the great guitar maker Simon Marty. So this is my recent instrument, also like very, very beautiful.
Lovely.
Yeah.
I love at the back, it's beautiful.
Yeah, it's picturesque, right? And so this guitar, all music on my, it's about the touch CD I record on this guitar. And I also have a Cedar, Simon Marty from 2007, and I won all my competitions on that other guitar. And it's for me like the spring and the summer guitar, and the other one is autumn and the winter guitar. And but actually I also combine them from time to time. It depends on the projects, and I also have CDs where I recorded on both guitars on one CD. And of course, I'm also open to collaborate with other guitar makers. I'm always open to play on them and to have, you know, like a new touch. But at home, I have my two babies.
So talking about the guitar naturally, that leads us to talk about maybe about a little bit about the strings you use.
I have so many questions about the strings, and that's a perfect moment also to explain and show actually which strings I'm using. I tried Savarez strings, I think about 20 years ago, and I was so surprised that they're so thin and such a bright color with such a nice vibration. So I was like, wow, that's really nice. And so from that moment, I'm just only playing Savarez strings, and I tried different models. But it's always been a high tension. It's like I need that very quick response. Plus, I'm a little bit lazy on changing strings. And I noticed Savarez is the only string that lasts long. So I don't have from each concert to change to the new set, because, well, I really don't like to do this even with a special machine. Oh, I don't like it. So that's why it's another reason why I like Savarez, because I know it always will sound good and fresh. Well, and I found for me the real like ideal combination for the spruce. I like to use this Cantiga Creation, because it has nylon, the first and second nylon. And it makes it much warmer, the sound of very bright guitar and very loud guitar. So it's a good touch to the to this guitar. And I have this Allianz for my Cedar Simon Marty guitar, because it has carbon, and that's better for the Cedar guitar, because it's it gives the right brightness in the sound. So I use those two.
Maybe you want to tell us a little bit about your academy, and I'd be very curious to know a little bit more about your, maybe you can show the Savarez TV viewers a little bit of one or two techniques that something that you would like to transmit and teach your pupils online. I don't know, something like your tremolo picking or something.
So I want to share within this academy my approach to how I became not just a guitarist, but how I became a musician and what is important for me to be a musician. So one thing is, of course, it's your perfect body and mind and hand position and... this, you know, this when I gave the recording once in an airplane to a stranger, just to listen, because they were curious, the girl is struggling with the guitar, who is she? And then they just find me on Spotify, and then they think there are two people, you know, like said, no way, this playing just two people. I said, no, we have to go, when we land and we get out of the airplane, I will show you. And I show this to him. He's like, what? How you do this? Simple. It just... So many people say, we so much want to study tremolo with you. It is so difficult and it is my dream. It's easy. But you have to know how. So what I want to do in the academy, I want to make things more simple and go step by step to explaining also about your posture, because it's very important, also about your concentration. And the breathing, because if you are too tense, you cannot play, you know, and how to control the breathing. And then also about how to play with a thumb and how to play with the ring finger so that they really be equally, because for the tremolo, it's very important to have both voices on front and not that, for example, tremolo doesn't come like also this. When we know that M and I are very strong fingers, but here on the tremolo we have to play soft. And there are several ways how to make them soft and relax and have a full control, you know, to become the boss over your fingers. Because I always say that your hands, this is your first instrument, your mind and your hands, this is your first instrument. And it doesn't matter what guitar you have. You're just able to play on any guitar, on any instrument. This is the first instrument. And they're very simple, but you know, like many steps, slowly, day by day, to learn how to make it possible. And I know everyone is able to play tremolo. So this is how I'm... Yes, ready to share all my knowledge, and not only about tremolo, of course. So in this academy, we will also look at a different perspective also on painting and music, and also on some professional disease and tension in the fingers and how to release those tensions, sort of yoga for hands. There will be also very simple but very necessary music music theory, but on the guitar. Music forms what we, you know, what we have and what we have to know, and that we don't get a mistake like the vowels. Sorry. Right, so that we don't put any accents on the third that I hear so often, especially by kids, you know, like you never dance the vals and 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, you know, and so these kind of little things, and also knowing what vals is and where is the accent, so make you to play your favorite pieces in the right way, you know, in the correct way, so the music doesn't suffer, the music opens up, and it opens up your potential, your love, because you enjoyed it a lot more. I also tease on Instagram and I ask, so how it's better to play, like in or up? So, and of course, when they hear it, they say, of course, in and not, because if I play like in, or if I play up, that's a big difference. So they hear it. But like only when I show two possibilities, they always choose for the best one. And in the academy, we learn also how to, well, to apply the best in their performance and their playing.
Where can people reach out to you if they want to join?
Yes, we have a very special website name because it's classicalguitar.academy. It's Irina Kulikova _guitar for the Instagram, and Facebook, Irina Kulikova, classical guitarist.
Okay, well, thank you so much for your generosity and your time, Irina. And once again, from the whole Savarez team, we wish you all a very, very happy birthday, because it's right now today.
A surprise, surprise, a live surprise.
Wow. Hello.
Hello.
They're amazing flowers.
I love you, baby. Love you, baby. Bye, everybody.
Bye.